used to say to myself he'd gone to Neverland.
Where?
Neverland. It's a wonderful place.
You feel more like pirates?
Look, I'm Peggy the Pirate.
I'm Blind Beard the Pirate.
Long live the Hook!
You wouldn't dare fight old Hook, man to man.
Just gotta grow up.
When you grow up,
we ought to have Jake growed up.
And look at her now, so mature.
Oh, real mature.
Hamzo's so mature now.
Oh, that's really mature.
Andy, it's all grown up.
You ready to put away your toys and grow up?
We have to be mature, but we can't lose the spirit of childlike wonder.
Ah!
Dentists. The first thing they grab is an iron hook.
It's hopeless.
Oh, this big pole and hook.
Rob has his spy hook. He's heading back.
Those are hooks.
I'm a monster.
I'll see him wriggle like a worm on a hook.
Beware the hook.
Why, I never thought of that.
This. You're gonna get hooked on that.
Watch this.
It is all Requiem, Mass Boy.
Ready to lose the other one?
They're off the hook.
Game's over, hook.
Not my hook.
Welcome to Impact 2011. We are here on our 20th year of Impact, and we are in the final stages of Impact. Your name is?
I'm Chelsea Fesley.
Let's start this. Hi, I'm Josh, still from North Carolina.
USA! USA! USA!
Make the most bizarre noise you can possibly make. Good noise. Make the weirdest noise you can make possible.
Why?
Right now.
Why?
Please. Come on, tell me.
Wee! I don't know.
How about a chimera?
What's a chimera?
Nah.
Basilisk.
What do you mean?
Your favorite Harry Potter animal. Make a noise.
I don't watch Harry Potter that way.
Pterodactyl. The Impact Gargoyle started 5 years ago. It's been a classic gag that we've run ever since. Where we set up a unsuspecting camper who's walking inside the door and have someone jump out at him. I just know him as Tapmaster. Tapmaster Allen's gonna tap for us again. Now what? Go talk to more people.
All right, is this your natural hair?
Yes, this is my natural hair.
And how do you do that? How do you get that?
Well, you know, I try not to wash it a lot. When I'm in the shower, I hold it up like this.
It's kind of apparent.
And just wash my, yeah, and then, you know, just kind of rub some stuff into it and just kind of, yeah.
Nice hair.
Thank you so much.
Yeah,
give you props on it. Thank you.
Bear on a bicycle.
Everybody likes this.
Bear.
Good job.
May you experience the love of Christ, though it is too great to fully understand. And then you will be made complete with all the fullness of life and power that comes from God. Now all glory to God, who is able, through his mighty power work within us, to accomplish infinitely more than we might ask or think. Glory to him in the church and in Christ Jesus through all generations, forever and ever. Amen.
The hope of nations, Savior, he can move the mountains. My God is mighty to save. He is mighty to save.
But all that I am, praise the Lord, may I never forget the good things he does for me. He forgives all my sins. He heals all my diseases. He redeems me from death and crowns me with love and tender mercies. He fills my life with good things. My youth is renewed like an eagle's.
Love you, Lord. And I lift my voice.
strength always. I will not fear. His promise is true. My God will come through always, always.
Back at home, that you're willing to give up a week of your summer to come here with a bunch of friends and a bunch of Christians to be able to worship God. You communicated that. What I want you to understand is you're always communicating something. But it's so important for us to have the right language. It's so important for us to have the right message that we're communicating. You're communicating something whether you like it or not. Let's make sure that we're communicating the right thing.
Up in the morning, gotta be fresh, gotta go upstairs, gotta have my bowl, gotta have cereal, seeing old friends with frisbee throwing, time is ticking on, everybody rushing, gotta get to the arena, gotta get my spot, no saving seats, should I sit on his side, or maybe on that side, gotta make my mind up, do I want to win, it's impact, gotta get on impact, everybody's looking forward to walling impact, kicking it at impact, everybody's looking forward to his black jeans,
worshiping
yeah!
ball racing
yeah!
fun, looking forward to power force
135 in the middle of free time, sweating so hard, been playing four square, shower thinking about shower,
oh no you don't,
I got this, you got this, my friend is by my right, hey, I got this, you got this, now you know it. Do I play some dodgeball? Wait in line for Starbucks? Gotta make my mind up, or do I go see Grits? It's impact. Gotta get down on impact. Everybody's looking forward to Dr. Cobra. Impact. Pity the fool at impact. Mr. T.
Pitying.
Yeah!
Yeah! Foo. What is it that they are gonna blend?
Last week was
work camp.
Today is impact. We so excited. We gonna pass the ball today. Impact ends on Saturday and Sunday comes afterwards. I don't want this week to end.
I am at impact, so chilling in the golf cart, in the front seat. I'm driving, cruising fast lane, switching lanes. Oops, I just hit a team. Passing by is a bear on a bike. Doesn't stop to help. Kid, are you all right? Where's your liability form?
Impact,
oh man, security!
Impact, gotta get down on impact. Everybody's looking forward to the guy who hit the camper. Impact. Almost as good as Uplift. Everybody's looking forward to the group Devos tonight.
Partying.
Yeah!
Partying.
Yeah!
Fun.
Looking forward to the whole week.
Partying.
Yeah!
Partying.
Yeah!
Fun.
It's
baptizing.
Yeah!
Baptizing.
Impact.
Devoting.
Everybody looking forward to Walling and Seedman.
Pizza.
Impact. Where's some Steve Davidson? Everybody looking forward to the Devos tonight. Oh, yeah.
Devoting.
Yeah.
Devoting.
Woo!
It is so fun.
Where can I order my pizza?
Shut up, fool.
Y'all ready for this?
your face was slate. Won't you give him a hand because he only has one? I'll give you the steel-handed stingray, Captain James A. Hook. A vast, vast sea of prepubescent... Wait a minute, that was for Junior Impact. You all have reached puberty. At least most of you. So welcome, you pubescent, parasitic sacks of entrails. Allow me to introduce myself. My name is Captain James... A. Hook.
Always say that.
And I'm the king of the world!
You're the king of the world. It's just you and me on this big boat.
But Mr. Smee, I like big boats and I cannot lie. No other captain could deny. And Mr. Smee, oh my goodness, have you seen the size of the booty on this ship?
Was that a personal comment, mate? Are you talking to Smee? Are you talking to Smee?
On your mark, get set, go!
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 Go! Go!
Go!
Go!
Go!
Go!
Serious scene. Who are you?
Do you know how to make your own antifreeze?
I do not know how to make my own antifreeze. How do I make my own antifreeze, Patrick? You take away her fur coat. Hey! Take away her fur coat. On the count of three, we're gonna get Patrick a hey-ya. One, two, three. Hey!
So, what do you get when you eat beans and onions?
Oh, I don't like
where this. What do you get when you eat beans and onions? Onions.
Tear gas.
Oh. You gotta get up.
Oh, here is the plan of the evil pirate. There goes my hat. There goes my hat. My hat and my mustache keep falling off. Hopefully everyone's distracted by that bird.
Maybe he knows a little bit about the plan, but not all.
I like that plan.
Here's likely an exotic chili dog.
No.
A sonic pickle dog.
Hot and spicy baconette.
Oh, right.
Some salsa. Yeah. For the twang. Some spicy mustard, which will make this place awful.
We recently integrated, and we had a great team as
The players of the white and black persuasion came together and joined together as a force. We were undefeated until our star linebacker Bertia was hurt in a car crash.
Did you win a game?
No, we lost 73-1.
What?
Yeah, we kicked an extra point. You show me how to fly, boy.
I'll show you how to fly without the assistance of anyone else.
No one else assisting us at this time.
We will be flying all alone.
That's incredible. You can fly. That's amazing.
Great.
Mr. T, I grasp. You got that right, sucker. It's me, Mr. T. What do you want? I'm trying to get my run on. And so we chatted for a little bit. I said, listen, little boy, you can't play football. I'm going to take that football and slam it on your face because I'm Mr. T.
It's a classic. It's a children's classic.
I don't like that play. I like mine much better. I'm going to kill the flying boy. We're going to take these three right here with us for insurance.
We are farmers.
Hello. I'm Lipscomb University President Randy Lowry, standing here in front of the Allen Bell Tower. I can't be with you at Impact this week. I'm in California at a conference. But I hope you really enjoy this edition of Flannel Board Theater. And please, come to Lipscomb.
Good morning, children. This is the Baron von John Jacob Jingleheimer without the Schmidt. Silence! And allow me to be the first to welcome you to another year. Our 10th year of Flannel Board Theater. Which makes me say, well, well. Boys and girls, today we can think of no better place to begin than with the classic tale of Peter Pan, a story written by J.M. Barrie, today being played by Alexander Campbell.
Listen, I don't mind if you enjoy my story, but please don't add or take away from it. And no clapping!
Our story begins in London, today being played by a 1950s church, which was a church that was on fire. And had recently added a hotel annex to the side of the church, which was named after one of the summer's hottest movies. And in London, there lived a family, a darling family.
There was John,
being played by this 1950s basketball kid who had shorts that would surely get him kicked out of Impact, even if he had been a girl. And Wendy, played by this little 1950s schoolgirl, and Michael, being played by Zacchaeus, and their dog Nana, being played by this howling monkey.
Hey!
Little did they know that they were about to learn how to fly, and then they would travel to a magical place where they would fight a pirate who only had one hand, and, well, hold on, that's getting the cart before the horse. Every night in her nursery, little Wendy would read a bedtime story to help her brothers go to sleep. And she would pick something really, really boring. This time, she chose to read from her AP U.S. History exam.
James K. Polk was the 11th president of the United States. He died of cholera.
And this would help them fall fast asleep. And sometimes, to help, she would also show them how to count sheep. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. Fast asleep! And one night, while the darling children were fast asleep, a mysterious young flying boy appeared at their window and pulled back the curtain that separated the holy place from the Holy of Holies. And his name was Peter Pan.
Hello, my name's Peter Pan.
Today being played by Timmy the Bible School Boy wearing a baptismal gown. And Peter Pan awoke the children and asked them this question.
Do you want to know how to fly?
And they all replied,
yes, sure, yeah, sure.
And so Peter Pan told them to think happy thoughts.
Think happy thoughts!
Which the children could not do because just before bed they had seen The Notebook and had read Where the Red Fern Grows and watched Old Yeller. And so when this did not work, Peter had to come up with another plan. And so he taught them how to fly on a magic carpet. Today being played by the coat of many colors.
I can show you the world. Magic place full of wonder.
Silence! And so, after several hours of flying, which took them across the international dateline, which caused them to lose a day and actually go back in time, they landed at a magical place called Neverland, which was full of unsearchable treasures and things they had never seen before. And just as they landed in Neverland, they saw off in the distance, approaching the shore, a large vessel, the Jolly Roger, today being played by the Ark of the Covenant. When much to their wondering eyes should appear, out of the window of the Ark came, well, first came a raven and then a dove. But after that, emerged two of the most nefarious villains ever known to the ocean. Captain Hook and his first mate, Mr. Smee. Today, being played by John the Baptist and his Jaguar. Wow, wow, wow. Years ago, Captain Hook had lost his hand, and it was replaced with a large metal hook. Today, being played by the large mysterious statue from the Book of Daniel, which no one has any idea what it means, which makes it perfect for flannel board theater. His hand had been eaten by a large, scary crocodile. Today, being played by Little Bitty Spooky Kitten. And we all know that there is only thing, one thing worse than a little bitty spooky kitten. And that is four little bitty spooky kittens. Having already captured the Darling family, Captain Hook then turned his sights on the Lost Boys, where he held them prisoner by loading them aboard the Jolly Roger, but he made them go in two by two, except for the ones who were clean, and he made them go in by sevens. But Captain Hook's real plan was unknown to everyone, for you see, Captain Hook was a communist, and his plan was to revive the Soviet Union. But what no one saw was off in the distance. When suddenly it got much closer, and it was the USA whale that ate them all.
USA! 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 USA!
Hello, I'm Lipscomb University President Randy Lowry. Nestled here in the hills of Neverland, where all I can imagine are acres and acres of potential campus improvements. Now, while I recognize that Peter Pan is one of the favorite stories of the world,
I love it!
I am not so sure I agree, and I'm going to write a letter to the world to let them know that. And please, come to Lipscomb.